Good morning, everyone. I've got the pleasure to present the Bioplastics Market Update 2017 to you, which we compiled together with the research experts from the Nova Institute. And I promise I'll try and keep it short so we can commence with the more interesting presentations today on bio-based products and materials and on sustainability and recycling today. So currently, bioplastics make up around 1% of the 320 million tons of plastics produced worldwide every year. But with more innovative materials, new products, new applications emerging, the bioplastics market is actually growing quite dynamically. And the reasons for that are, on the one hand, the increased consumer awareness for the environmental impact of our consumption patterns, the knowledge about the finite nature of our fossil resources. And on the other hand, we see an increasing number of big brands and manufacturers looking for innovative ways to reduce their environmental footprint, the environmental footprint of their products and services. And they are looking into the benefits and the properties of bioplastics. And at the same time, and with a special view to Europe, the commitment to the transition to the circular economy and the increasing political support for the bioeconomy on a whole, as we heard yesterday, are creating a momentum of growth for the bioplastics industry in Europe. The global production capacities of bioplastics are predicted to grow by 20% in the next 5 years, from currently around 2.05 million tons to up to 2.4 million tons in 2022. Bio-based durable materials make up the main share of the production capacities, with materials like bio-based PE, bio-based PET, but also bio-based PA. But we also see a decisive increase of the biodegradable materials such as PLA, PHA, and starch blends. But let's have a more detailed look into the segment of biodegradable plastics. Here, materials like PLA and PHA are the main growth drivers in this field. PHA is a relatively new material that has been in development for quite a while and has now finally entered the market at commercial scale. And with around 40 companies planning to enter the PHA market in the coming years, the production capacities for PHA are actually predicted to triple in the next 5 years. The production capacities of PLA are also predicted to grow by 50% in the next 5 years. PLA is a very versatile material that is also available in high performance grades. That makes an ideal replacement for PP, PS, or ABS materials in more demanding applications. In the segment of the bio-based durable plastics, we see that bio-based PE is going to increase due to new players and new production capacities coming online in the next years in Europe. The predicted increase of bio-based PET, however, has not been realized at the rate that was predicted in the past years and actually had to be corrected downwards. But what we see is that the focus has been shifted towards development of PEF. PEF is a new polymer that is expected to enter the market at commercial scale in 2020. It is comparable, very similar to PET, but it's 100% bio-based and it's said to have better barrier and thermal properties, so it's an ideal material for packaging of beverages, food and non-food products. We also expect bio-based PP to be available at commercial scale on the market in 2022 with new companies entering the market, and PP, bio-based PP, probably has a very big growth potential due to the very wide range of the use of PP in a wide range of applications and products. One other very important biopolymer is bio-based polyurethanes, which are not included in our market data update this year. Bio-based polyurethanes have huge growth potential in a very well-established market that's actually predicted to grow even faster than the conventional polyurethane market. We have not included it in our data this year, however, because there's no reliable data on the actual bio-based content and the actual volumes of the bio-based polyurethanes. But let's now have a quick look at where bioplastics are already being used. If we look closer, bioplastics are already part of our everyday life. They are used in a great range of consumer products, from catering and tableware, electronics, shopping bags, sports equipment and apparel, toys, coffee capsules, cosmetic products, automotive sectors, and a lot more. And with a look at the actual numbers, we see that packaging is still the main sector for bioplastics, with around 60% of the production capacities going into the packaging market. However, we also see an increasing uptake of bioplastics in other market segments, such as consumer goods, automotive and transport, building and construction, textiles and agriculture. With a view to the regional development of the production capacities, Asia is and is going to remain the major hub for the production of bioplastics because of the feedstock availability in that region. 20% of the production capacities of bioplastics are currently located in Europe, and that share is predicted to grow to 25% in the next 5 years. Europe is very strong in the field of research and development of bioplastics, and with the said stronger political support of the bioeconomy and bioplastics industry, we do hope and predict that that share is going to increase. Bio-based plastics are made from a wide range of renewable feedstocks. Currently, bioplastics are mainly derived from plants that are rich in carbohydrates, such as corn, sugarcane, or sugar beet. But we also see an increasing number of projects that are exploring ways to use lignocellulosic feedstocks or organic waste feedstocks to produce bioplastics. And these feedstocks will become a very interesting and viable option in the mid and long term. The actual land used to grow the feedstock to produce bioplastics is currently around 0.8 million hectares, which translates to around 0.02% of the global agricultural area, 97% of which is mainly used for pastures and production of food and feed. And even despite the growth predictions of the bioplastics market, the land use share is not going to increase and remain around 0.02%. Yet still, the debate around the use of biomass for the production of bioplastics is still highly emotionally charged, but these numbers do and should show that there is no competition between the use of biomass for the production of bioplastics and for the production of food and feed. And with that, I promise to keep it short. You can find more information in the market data report on your tables. Also, you find some more information on our website in a few hours once the press release has gone out. You can always approach me here today or send me an email anytime. Thank you very much.